puts the puck in deep. Inside 9 minutes to go. Third period. Watch it again.
And now Roslovic is going right down the tunnel. I believe he got cut from that hit from Huberdeau. Huberdeau pleading his case with the Columbus bench. Now Klapka's getting in there.
And a word to Branson,
yes.
And we'll see how the rest of these penalties shake down, but Huberdeau definitely the first one going to the box. Looks like the Jackets with the lead will go on the power play. We come back 3-2 in Calgary.
And now the two officials are going to review this call. And here's the hit. And Roslovic with his back to him, and I believe it's the visor as well that cuts Roslovic. And I think that's what Huberdeau was trying to tell somebody on the Columbus bench, that you can tell from Huberdeau's reaction. Of course, he didn't mean to do that, but there's quite a bit of blood on Roslovic, so
that's so. The call on the ice, as you mentioned, Kelly, was 5 minutes, but yeah, they do review those, yeah, right? So it can be downgraded.
Yes.
And they're having a long look at it. Corey Sabret and Steve Cazzari. Roslovic hit Uyghur earlier in the game. Remember, Uyghur was happy about that. So I wonder if there might have been some retaliation. I don't know. Speculating here. Uyghur had to shake that one off.
Yes.
Just curious, because Huberdeau went at Roslovic a couple of times on that shift, and then finally that hit there sent him to the box.
Yes. It seems as though it's... Okay, here's that Roslovic hit on Uyghur in the second period, which kind of banged up Uyghur for a bit. He's unsuspecting and he gets hit from behind. Okay, I think we're going to get the call now.
After reviewing the play, Calgary's number 10 has been assessed a 5-minute game misconduct for boarding.
Well, I don't think there's any surprise there, Rick. It seemed as though that was the call was going to stand.
So, obviously, not great for the Flames, down by a goal, only 8.5 left. Yep. You're shorthanded for 5 minutes. And now you're down another forward. They're already without A.J. Greer.
But they are terrific shorthanded.
They've got 10 this year.
Yep.